That is National High School at Bacao, Dumaran, Palawan. It was badly damaged by typhoon Odette, internationally known as Rio, and we will try to go inside and see the damage. So let's go. Let's go inside. Should be careful on such objects because pieces of roof still can fly in the wind. There may be some broken glass, some flying plywood from the ceiling due to water damage. And the longer the school remains without roof, the more damage is done to what's inside. So they wouldn't let us pass there. So let's try to pass this way. Hope we can go up to the second floor. This school building is newly constructed. Last time I've been in Bacao, it was still under construction. And it's so sad that basically just after it was finished, first was closed for students because of pandemic. So no face-to-face classes, all classes are through modules. Oh, look at that. That should be dangerous. That might be dangerous. And the roof is gone here. They wanted to open on January 3rd, but they obviously will not be able to. So no roof here, ceiling just dropped. Inside classroom, that is just a mess. Again, no ceiling, no roof, a lot of water damage. I'm not sure if you can try and go on another side, but let's try to check what is there. There is another staircase on another side. That's some horror movie. Those sounds, it's a horror movie. So let's go try to pass on another side. Maybe we can go around not to pass through this mud. I think this mud is from landslide. It was a small, well, relatively small landslide from this hill. And some of the mud flew to the school. So maybe that's the reason they put this tape here. But we'll try to go around. School is usually the strongest building in the village. So it's financed by government. They have some funds to build school. But now, again, due to pandemic and due to extent of the damages, it's not the only school that is damaged. There is a lot of schools in remote areas that are in similar situation. It will take them years to rebuild, and again, students will not be able to learn for who knows how long anymore. So yeah, here we can pass, and let's see what's inside the classroom. So that's closed. Again, no ceiling, even though roof remained, ceiling fell. Let's go to next one. Again, roof hanging from the top. Here, let's try to pass carefully. Yeah, again, ceiling gone completely. Oh, you can open here. So ceiling is gone completely. There is still something on the whiteboard, on the blackboard, whatever. Yeah, it's green board. So again, even that most of the roof remained, the ceiling just dropped. So what happens when the wind goes inside, when it just breaks a small piece of the roof, so the pressure goes inside and it blows away everything which is on the way. And then water do the rest of the job and destroy what wind had not destroyed. So it is a beautiful school. Now cannot be used for education. And here you see what the teacher was telling us about their modules that they were handing out to children, to students, so they can learn at home. Even those modules are damaged by water, so they have to postpone education at all. Even this inefficient home-based education, they need to postpone. They was really hoping that could reopen in January 3, and finally, after 2 years of offline classes, or online classes, offline in remote areas, they can they thought they will be able to restart offline classes, but they will not be able to, obviously, because that is badly damaged and will take a lot of time, a lot of funds to recover. So let's work together and help them to recover and to restart, because children, they cannot wait for years without growing up. They cannot wait for years without education.